Jim Alexander here with Real Talker at the premiere of Zach Galifianakis' Between Two Ferns, the movie. Yes, the Funnier Die internet sensational show is now a movie on Netflix. I'm talking to the director, the cast, the crew, whoever's coming through. So stay tuned for my interviews coming up next. I'm sure this wasn't a long time coming. You never thought this is going to turn into a movie and we're going to have a premiere here. When the series kind of started off, I know you joined in 2010. Is that true? Or
Funny or Die?
Yeah.
2008.
Okay. Yeah. I got my dates wrong. What was the initial kind of idea or concept behind the show, and where did you see it going initially?
So Zach Galifianakis and Scott Aukerman came up with the show already, so I started producing it when I got to Funny or Die in 2008. And I just, one, I thought it was just objectively funny, and Zach's sensibility and just everything about it was so surprising. There had never been an interview show like this. And so when I saw how much fun they were having and how much the talent like was in on the joke and having fun, just poking fun at things like this, you know, celebrity interviews in Hollywood, I was just like, we gotta keep it going. And so Funny or Die produced all the videos other than the first two, so probably over 20 of them. And then when Zach and Scott had the idea for the movie, it was a natural fit for us to produce it, and we took it to Netflix, and here we are at this premiere.
How long was the movie kind of in the making, the idea of concept, like, let's turn it into a movie, and until this point? Was this a long time coming?
Yes and no. I mean, nothing happens fast in Hollywood. I would say they started thinking about it when we did this Comedy Central Fern special probably 5-6 years ago. And then I think in earnest we started talking more about it about 2-2.5 years ago. Yeah.
What's something about Zach that people wouldn't know about? Like a casual person that you've experienced through working alongside him and knowing him. What's something about him that most people would find surprising, I guess?
Zach is very aware of the world around him and what's important. And he knows that this is amazing that we get to work in Hollywood and tell stories, and certainly some stories are very important. But comedy, I love that he doesn't take things too seriously. He knows that Hollywood and celebrity culture is kind of a silly thing. That's why he loves doing Between Two Ferns. And so, he's a great family man. He's a salt of the earth kind of guy. So I don't know if
he's
that's
like a
surprising.
Real person. No, that's a good thing.
I mean, we're all real people,
yeah,
but
exactly.
He's not driven by fame and accolades. He loves doing the work. He loves going home to his family, and he's just, he's good people.
And, you know, kind of on that topic, the show kind of exposes the, like, we had huge celebrities on him, from McConaughey, I mean, the A-list of A-list, but it shows the real side of him, kind of the human side that sometimes, you know, there's a misconception, you know, they're always running from paparazzi, like, you want to be secret, but it really shows their personalities and uncovers their real self in a lot of ways. What have you kind of observed and discovered over that, seeing all these major stars come through and just being in on the jokes and being so open and comfortable with themselves?
I think that's a really good question. I mean, I think everyone has a different experience with it, obviously, but generally speaking, people love it. It's not a long shoot, you know. Zach never wants to really make anyone feel bad or punch down. You know, we're not, obviously we're putting them down, but it's like the characters are putting themselves down, and we would never want, and Zach and Scott certainly would never want someone to actually feel really, really upset about it. And in fact, if someone said to us, hey, do you mind like not using that joke? Of course, we wouldn't want to use a joke that someone wasn't comfortable with. So, you know, I think people, that creates just a comfort level so that they can kind of go in and have fun. And of course, we want them to have fun and also have it be funny, you know, because no one wants to be in the bad Between Two Ferns. I don't think there is one, but, you know, it's a pretty high standard.
There you go. I mean, you've kept up to it. Thank you so much.
Thanks
really
so much.
Appreciate
What's
it.
Your name again?
Jim Alexander.
Thanks, Jim.
Thank you so much.